Hey, this is Overpass Insights. My name is Eric and I make apps. Now today I want to talk a little bit about the COVID reporting glitch in England and why it is important to log everything. Okay, so yesterday morning I'm reading the news and apparently there's been this big fiasco where due to a computer glitch, 16,000 cases of COVID have gone unreported. And it's kind of a serious thing because they've been missed off like track and trace, so they have to go back and see if they can catch these people. The infection can keep going out and all of it's put down to a computer glitch. Now, as a technology person, whenever I hear computer glitch, I always wonder what it is. Was it like a server failure? Was it a cron job that didn't go on? Was it a bug? Is it like the developer forgot to do something? Or is it somebody who was supposed to do something a certain time didn't do it? I always wonder what it is, right? But anyway, it was kind of a serious story here. Now, if you don't live in England, you probably don't care about it, but the reasons for it were fascinating. Because there's a story on BBC yesterday about how Excel, Microsoft Excel, was the reason for those 16,000 coronavirus cases to go unreported. So basically what was happening was everything was coming in a CSV file, which is fine, right? A lot of us store things in a CSV file. And they were being aggregated into a Microsoft Excel workbook. However, it wasn't an XLSS notebook, XLSX notebook, you know, the later versions of Excel. It was the early one, XLS. So XLS files could only hold like 65,000 rows. So even though you were having the CSV files with, you know, whatever, a lot more than that, when it was imported into Excel to aggregate it, it was losing a lot of that data. Of course, if they used XLSX, then they would have had like over a million rows, right? And it was kind of strange how like everything, there was like this one weak point in the chain. It was like using the wrong format of Excel caused all of these problems. And the reason I thought it was interesting was because I had a similar thing happen to me working at an investment bank, although this was back in like 2006, right? So basically what happened, we had there was this MIS system, like these management reporting. I was kind of brought in to help put it online. So there was like one guy who was not a developer, but he was really good with Excel. He was really good with VBA, or he kind of learned as he went. It was kind of like their junior guy, and he built up this elaborate reporting system, which pulled in data from all these different places and gave a, you know, ran all these macros. It took hours to run. I mean, Excel is really good for reporting. It's really good for reporting. If you've ever worked on a system where somebody gives you something that was done in Excel and they say, okay, we want to put this into an app or we want to put this online, the difficulty is the flexibility of Excel. You have to say, okay, you can't do just like a pivot table whenever you want. You can't just, you know, whatever. You have to tell us what you want to do so we can build that into the system. I mean, Excel is really, really flexible. It's just not very scalable. So he was having this, all these Excel reports which are running, it was Excel and Access and all this VBA stuff was going, and every day he's reported doing this report, and it was taking him, you know, 6 hours every day just doing all this kind of stuff, mainly because the macros were taking so long to run and everything like that, right, which was fine. So you know, me and another developer, we were brought in to basically duplicate that online. So we were writing the cron job, or the Windows task scheduler, because it was a Windows-based application, just to take those files and then pull them into a central database, and then we're building. So once we get everything in a central SQL database, we can start doing the front end there. So my job was to write the import routine. And of course I had like, you know, try to make it very flexible. So whatever format they bring in the future, we just have a config file, pull everything in. And one of the things that I did, which I wasn't asked for, this is one of the things, as a developer, I wasn't asked to do this, but I wanted to have like one table, which was just the manifest table. I call it the manifest because every time we import it, I just want to say what time was it imported, what location, because sometimes it's FTP to a certain drive, you pick it up from a certain drive, sometimes it's pulling it from a different database, sometimes you have an API feed, it was like all these different connectors coming in, right? And so I kind of wanted to know how many records I'm actually pulling in, so I just put that in the manifest table, so how many records are actually coming in. And we had a few of them which were, they weren't Excel files, they were CSV files, right? And it was after like 5 days of running this or doing all the other stuff, I realized that this CSV file always had the same number of rows, right? It was new data every single time, but it was always 65,365. It was like, it was a specific number, which I thought was strange. So I Googled that number and find out that's the exact limit of an XLS file, right? And so the first thing I did was I went to the head of the project and I said, this is really strange because this data is coming in as 65,000 and it's really strange that it's new data every day. These transactions are the same every day, but it's always that same number. And that's the exact same number as the limit of an Excel file. And he was like, well, how many should it be? And I was like, I don't know, because like that's further down the stream. Somebody's producing something, it's getting there. And he was kind of like, I wonder if I should tell anybody about this, right? Because it was like this, like business decisions were being made on this. This is how flimsy the reporting system was. Like it was hugely important to the investment bank, but like it was just, there was like this weak link in the chain. In the end, it was like, you know, I think it finally was reported. It went like, there was this big, I mean, it wasn't, I was so glad it wasn't my code. Like it was somebody else was doing something else into Excel and then putting it out there, right? But if we didn't log those things, we never would have found it. And who knows how many years that had been running that way, where they'd just been working off the wrong data. I mean, there's one good thing about this story, which is that they caught it early so that they didn't have this discrepancy in the reporting figures, because they did say, oh, you're using XLS, which is the 65,000 row limit, instead of, you know, using a later version of Excel, which you gotta question whether or not they should be using Excel anyway, but it depends on who's doing the job, I guess, right? Which leads me to logging, right? One of the things that I learned pretty early on, and I learned this a bit from experience, but I learned a lot from other developers, which is the importance of logging things, right? The importance of saying, okay, this, especially when it's automated, when you have an automated process, it's like, this happened at this time, this is the data we brought in, this is how long the process took, this is any exceptions that happened, right? You need to have that someplace. It doesn't need to be available to everybody, but you need to be able to get to it, right? And the same with, you know, deleting transactions, the same with you know, user activity if you can. As a developer, I've always been where I want to have everything logged if I can. Unless it's like it gets ridiculous and it really slows down the system, I want everything done. Because this is what happens. And you don't do the logs for your client. You don't do it because they ask you for it. You do it because you do it for yourself. Because this happens again. If you've been a software developer for a while, if you've done any projects for anybody for any particular amount of time, this kind of thing will happen. Eric, there's something wrong with your system. Oh, it's my system all of a sudden. Okay, Eric, there's something wrong with your system. The other day we put in all these rows and then they've just gone missing, right? It's just, we talked to everybody and nobody's, you know, nobody's been dealing with them and the values just changed. And so there's something weird going on there. Can you investigate it? And you're like, well, surely somebody's changed something. And they're like, no, we talked to everybody. We talked to everybody who has access to the system. Nobody's touched it, right? And then like when you have logging, I mean, it's nothing more satisfying than being able to go in and say, okay, actually those rows were deleted by Jill at 10:13. She also did this, this, and this. So she's the one who did it. It's just, oh, but she says she didn't. And then of course, you know, maybe she did something different, whatever. And then we track it down from there, but it's always better to have more information than not. And it's especially important when you have an automated system that runs without you looking at it. And it's really important with mobile applications too, because these things fail without you're not able to say, you know, look at the logs or whatever. You have to like say, send me a screenshot, or so having Crashlytics and analytics, even if you don't check it every day, it's important having those applications. So it was an interesting thing about the Excel. I was fascinated by it. You know, just from a technical point of view. I mean, I've been there, like nothing, you know, I hope nobody gets fired over it, but, you know, anyway, interesting story. And logging, always, as a developer, you always have to log things. You always have to have that manifest, that what's happening and when, so that when somebody comes back to you and says, how come it's not working, you can either say why it's not working or why, you know, track everything down. Anyway, just my thoughts for today. I hope you guys have a fantastic day. That is it for today. Stay healthy, stay safe, subscribe, like, all that stuff. And I'll talk to you again next time.